takes a bit of drilling. So from here, guys, last week we were showing you when we load the weight, close bar, bring your hips forward, and then pull the balance to get this weight. When I remove the frames, we were showing you this time, I'm going to cut an angle, so I'm going to hip escape. So when I break his posture, as he's falling, I put my foot on his hip and I hip escape. So I'm on my right side. Okay, so I've got his posture and I've created an angle. Now I want to maintain that angle. Okay? So Carl's three things that he's probably going to do from here. Let's just say I've closed my guard at this stage. He can get his angle back by walking his hips back to here, and now I'm flat on my back. Does that make sense? So from here, when I load the weight, I go forward, I cut an angle. So detail one is I keep my left foot on his hip. Okay? So from there, try to walk your hip back in. It's going to be very difficult, and I'm keep staying on my side. I'm maintaining the angle. The second thing, okay, that he can do is he can walk his head towards me. Okay? And now I'm flat on my back again. So I have to do the process over again. So from close guard, I swing my hands in, I put my foot on his hip as I hip escape. This time I put my hands on the side of his head. So if he tries to walk his hip in, I can't because of my foot here. If he tries to walk his head in, he can't. Again, detail when I'm making these frames, I want to make sure my arms are straight, because if they're bent, I'm using muscular strength to keep them off. And if he's a big guy, I'm going to be getting tired, so I just want to stiff arm him. So I'm aligning the bones of my arm, so I'm structurally strong. Okay, so I blocked off his hips, so he can't walk in this way. I blocked off his head, so he can't walk in this way. So I broke his posture and I maintained the angle, which is what I'm after. The third thing he can do is posture up. Okay. Last week we showed you from here when he breaks posture to bring you straight down. This time you want to cut this angle. Okay? So Carl keeps his foot on my hip. I can't walk this way. If he places his hands on the side of my hip, he can't bring my head in because I want to get him flat his back. The last thing I can do is I can posture up. Like if it's MMA, I'm posturing up his head. If it's Brazilian jitsu, passing. Okay, so this is where it gets a little bit difficult. When I break his posture, I'll take pull, I'm here. If Carl tries to posture up, I'll just put the back of his head. Like in Thai box and the Muay Thai clinch. But I have to be careful, because when he brings his head in, I need to switch it back again. So it's kind of this action, this and this. And if I keep my foot on his hip, okay, he's not going to be able to walk his hip. So the drill is, guys, it's just a drill, okay? Your partner's going to start off again, bro. Partners have the ribcage control. I swing my arms in, I pull him forward. As he's falling, I'm hip escaping. So I'm not crossing my legs here, I can walk the ship, but I want to maintain the angle so I'm on my side. Okay? And then this is going to set up all my triangles and stuff. Okay? But the detail is, I've got to be able to maintain that angle and keep the skills. So we're just going to play from here, guys. As Carl tries to posture up, I'll be keeping it here, pushing back. Okay, he's walking his hip in, and if we end up flat on the back again, we just start again. Swim in, great posture, just playing, control, here, here, and when the moment's right, next week we'll show you how to do the trick. Okay, so we're going to drill for five, guys, angle and posture drill.